Hello everybody, we're about to size some vents. I'm going to suggest that you do this all on a working layer that we can hide for the good drawing. So first we lay the venting out, then we put the drainage fixture units on the fixtures. We also put the size of the traps. Put the size of the then we show the accumulated fixture units and we measure the segments between the vents. So let's have a look, see what we've got here. So here's all my fixtures. And I put the trap sizes right there. So I've got 1 3-inch floor drain, gives me 3 drainage fixture units. I've got a water closet, it takes a 3-inch drain, 6 drainage fixture units. Urinals, I've got 2 of them, they take a 2-inch drain, 8 drainage fixture units, 2 times 4. Another water closet. Oh, looks like I've got that one wrong. That should be 6 drainage fixture units. Okay. 3-inch floor drain, 3 drainage. Oh, here we've got a lavatory and a water closet. So I put the drains up here. Drains, 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 drains. I also put in the lengths here. I'm going to add up all of those lengths so that it's that length there that's going to set the main sizing. Turns out I've already added them up here. Let's put that up here so we can see it. 2, 7, 2, 2.5, etc. It all adds up to 27 fixture units. So this one here is only going to have 3 fixture units on it. So 3 fixture units. The next one's going to have 9. Next one's going to have, 9 plus 8, so it's going to be 17. Going to add 6 to it, that's going to be 23. The next one we're going to add 3 to it, so it's going to be 26. Next one we're going to add 2, so it's going to be 28. Next one's going to be 2 more, so it's going to be 30. The last one's going to be 7, so it's going to be 37. Now, I need to go and find out what the vent size is going to be for all these drains. Vent size for these drains. So I'm going to go down into the 2.5 section. Stack vents, not the chart we want. We want the minimum size of traps here. So, water closets and floor drains, 3-inch. They're all going to be 1.5-inch vent. 2-inch for urinals. Going to have 1.5-inch vent. 1.25 for 1.25 pipes. So that's lavatories there. Okay, so let's go set those. 3-inch floor drain takes 1.5-inch. Pipe. So I'm going to put that here. 3-inch again, so it'll take 1.5-inch. 2 times 2 inch. So when I've got 2 fixtures, I can get away with a single vent for both fixtures. So a 2 inch drain, what does that take? 2 inch drain takes an inch and a half vent. Inch and a half again. 3 inch, inch and a half. Laboratory. 2 times inch and a quarter. Well, I can't go any smaller, so it's going to have to be inch and a quarter. So when we have 2 fixtures of inch and a quarter, we pretend there's only 1 fixture there, and we take the inch and a quarter. So same thing with the next one. Now this last one here, 7 fixture units, has an inch and a quarter and a 3 inch. We size the vent for the larger fixture. So that'll be another inch and a half. So we know we need at least an inch and a half because that's the size of our farthest fixture. It's an inch and a half vent. Now we've got to check it and see if maybe with that 27 meters, maybe we need to upsize this long line here a bit. So let's start looking at our actual sizing table. Oh, actually, I think I put the sizing table right here. I did. Okay. So 3 fixture units, that would put us here. Oh, we can go 30 meters with inch and a half. So we're good on that. That one's good. I guess we could say good. What's the next one? 9 fixture units. 9 fixture units would put us up here. Nine fixture units with inch and a half would only give us 15 meters, and we need 27 meters. So we're going to have to pick 2 inch for this next one. 2 inch is good up to 20 fixture units. Now I'm forgetting where we were. Was that 9 that we were working on? Seventeen would bring us up to there. 9. It's the 9 we were working on. So 9 is going to get us to here, and we're going to have to upsize it to 2 inch at the 9 fixture unit. So that's what we did. We couldn't use inch and a half, so we're inch and a half from there to there, 2 inch between those two. Notice I'm putting the numbers here on the pipes and not at the fixtures. If I put it at the fixtures, you can't tell whether I'm talking about this pipe or this pipe. So 17 fixture units. We're still talking 2 inch. Actually, how many fixture units does that? 20. 20 will do up to 46 meters, so until we get up to 20 fixture units, oh, here we are here, 23 fixture units, very next one. So 23 fixture units would take us to this one. We can do that with 2 inch. 26 fixture units will push us up to this one. 2 inch is good for 30 meters. 28 fixture units, 28, so we're still on that one, 30 meters. Actually, I think it's going to be that way all the way up. Two inch is good up to 42 fixture units. Okay, so those are all 2 inch. In the interest of making things simpler. Quite often we'll leave stuff off of drawings because you can figure out by looking at the drawing what the sizes are. So right from here, this 2-inch goes up to here. This could be a 3-inch depending on what's coming up here. But right up to here, we're 2-inch. So we don't really need any of these except for where it changes from 1.5 inches. So I'm going to put the 1.5 inches there and the 2-inch there. So that's telling us that we're 1.5 inches on this side of the T, we're 2-inch on this side. The rest of them I can just delete. Because I've got 2-inch at each end, so this is all 2-inch. So I'm going to make that delete those suckers. Ooh, deleted too many. Okay, let's just do a quick review here. We're 1.5 inches up from here. Most of these are 1.5 inches. We've got a couple 1.25 inches. We've got the accumulated fixture units. So that's that plus that, it accumulates to 9, plus that accumulates to 17. So it looks like we're good there. We've got all the pipe sizes. We've got the vertical pipe sizes and we've got the horizontal pipe sizes. So we're done and done. Thank you very much.